In this video, we're going to talk about how to do an if statement, and then we'll do a multiple if. Let's say we're going to have the sales tax column in column G. And let's say, actually, in Pennsylvania, which is where I live, and probably in some other states, if it's a meal, then there's no sales tax. If it's food, there's no sales tax. So right now, we'll say if it's dinner, then there's no sales tax. Otherwise, it's going to be 8%. So I'm going to say equals if, open parentheses. Now, the logical test is usually going to be some kind of comparison. So I'm going to say F2 equals dinner, and I have the word dinner in quotes. Now, in this case, case does not matter. Notice how I type it in lowercase, and it'll still find it, even though that's capitalized. Case does not matter too much, but spelling is really important. You have to spell it the same way. But notice how the word dinner is in quotes. So that'll be the logical test. I'm going to type in a comma. Then you have the value of true. Well, if that's true, I want zero as the sales tax. And then I'll type in a comma. Otherwise, it's going to be 8% times the amount. So I'll type in 8% times E2. And then we'll close the parentheses. So the whole thing says equals if, open parentheses, F2 equals dinner, and dinner is in quotes, of course, comma zero, comma 8% times E2, close parentheses. When I hit the enter key, that line is zero, of course, because that line is dinner. Now, I'd like to copy that formula all the way down the column. A quick way to do that is to use the speed fill. Now here's a really quick way to use the speed fill. I'm going to get the speed fill over here, and then we can just double click on that, and it's going to go all the way down. Now that only works when there's a column to the left of your current column, like there is here, and it went as far down as that other column, as we can see. Now let's look through that list. Here's a zero because that's dinner, and everything else has an actual number there. Now we can really format that to look a little bit better, so I'll highlight column G. And we'll just take away a couple of those decimal places really quick. And in this case, I'll make it a number with two decimal places. That'll be fine. Now, what if I also wanted lunch or breakfast to be zero as well? Notice how lunch actually got the sales tax. Here's one way to do a multiple condition in an if. There's actually multiple ways. But we're going to do something called an OR. So I'm going to go into the if function here. And I'm going to have another function. It's called OR. And then open another parentheses. Now, with the OR, you can have many, many conditions inside the OR. And if either one of those are true, then the whole thing is true. So then I'll say, comma, F2 equals lunch. And lunch is in quotes. Comma, F2 equals breakfast. And breakfast is in quotes. So that's the OR. And then I still have comma 0, comma 8% times E2. So let's read the whole thing. Equals if, open parentheses, OR, open parentheses, F2 equals dinner, of course dinner is in quotes, comma F2 equals lunch, and lunch is in quotes, comma F2 equals breakfast, and breakfast is in quotes, and this is going to close the parentheses for the OR. So all of that's part of the OR. Now if any one of those are true, then they'll get the zero, otherwise they'll get the 8%. I'm going to hit the enter key. Now let's copy that all the way down using the speed fill again. And now notice how the lunch items are now zero, because the OR is true. In that case, you know, it is a lunch item. And I bet if we find some breakfast items, that one is also zero, because now the OR is true there as well. So the OR gives you a way to do multiple conditions with your if. You can have as many conditions within that OR as you needed to. They're all separated by a comma. And then if any one of those are true, that makes the OR true. And then that makes the if use the true value instead of the false value. And that gives you some ideas on how to do a multiple condition within an if.